Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu. Now in this video, I'm going to discuss about the formula of specific latent heat. We will say SLH, specific latent heat. Now, specific latent heat is denoted by L, the letter L, and Q is the amount of heat release or absorb, and m is the mass of the object. So L equal to Q by m. L equal to Q by m. Specific latent heat is equal to amount of heat released by m by mass of the object. If you cross multiply, we get the value Q equal to L into m. This is the formula. Q equal to m into L. This is the formula for specific latent heat. We will solve many problems from this relation. Now here Q equal to amount of heat absorb or release, and m is the mass of the substance, and L is the specific latent heat. Specific latent heat. Now what are the unit of specific latent heat? Q is measured in joule and mass is measured in kg. So the unit for specific latent heat is joule per kg. SI unit is joule per kg. Okay. Here Q equal to m into L. Q equal to mass into specific latent heat. Now, look at the question number 1. Find the amount of heat required to change 10 gram of ice. Look, 10 gram of ice. Okay? At minus 5 degree centigrade. The temperature of the ice is minus 5 degree centigrade. So, find the amount of heat required to change 10 gram of ice at minus 5 degree centigrade to water at 20 degree centigrade. Here given, specific heat capacity of water given 4.2, specific heat capacity SHC of ice given 2.1, and specific latent heat fusion of ice given 336 joule per gram. This value, these terms are given. Now look at this. Here ice is converted into water. Means there is a change of state. Ice temperature of the ice is minus 50 degree centigrade, is converted into water 20 degree centigrade. Now first you draw this diagram. If you understand this, you will easily solve the problem. Now ice first, after getting heat minus 5 degree centigrade, the temperature of the ice minus 5 degree centigrade, will convert into, here ice, if we supplied heat, then the temperature of the ice changes from minus 5 degree centigrade to 0 degree centigrade. So here only the temperature change. Now again this ice, now temperature of the, right now the temperature of the ice is become 0 degree centigrade. Now this ice is ready to convert into water, means change of state. This ice is converted into water, temperature remains unchanged. Okay, 0 degree centigrade. Now this water, now this ice will become water, 0 degree. Now again by continuous supply of heat, this water will convert into, is change the temperature 20 degree centigrade. Okay, now here first ice convert into, ice change the temperature minus 5 degree centigrade to 0 degree. Okay, so here only temperature change. So we will use formula MC delta T. Here ice to water, temperature remain constant but state change. So we will use formula, which formula? ML. And here again temperature change, water to water. Okay, temperature change, water 0 degree centigrade and the water 20 degree centigrade. So we will use this formula MC delta T. So here amount of heat Q1 this is Q1, this is here Q2, and this is Q3. So the total heat required, Q1 plus Q2 plus Q3, that is total heat required equal to Q1 plus Q2 plus Q3. So for Q1, MC delta T, MC delta T. For Q2, ML, ML. And for Q3, MC delta T. So put the value here. MC, here which M? Here solid ice, 10 gram of ice, 10 gram of ice. Value of C for ice is 2.1, and delta T minus 5 degree centigrade to 0 degree centigrade. How much change? 5 degree change. So MC delta T. Now M into L, Q2. M into L, mass of the ice is 10, that will convert into water, and latent heat of fusion of ice is given 336 joule. Putting the value, and again Q3 MC delta T. Now this one, mass of the water, that ice 10 gram is converted into 10 gram of water, so the mass of the water is also 10, and specific heat capacity of water given 4.2, and delta T, change in temperature 20 degree centigrade to 0 degree centigrade to 20 degree centigrade, so change in temperature 20 minus 0, so 20. By putting this and solving, we get the value 4305 joule. So this amount of heat required to change this 10 gram of ice in 10 gram of water, whose temperature is minus 5 degree centigrade to 20 degree centigrade. Okay, remember this one. First, ice is not directly converted into 20 degree centigrade. Whatever the temperature of ice will given, first it will come into 0 degree, and then this ice is converted into water, same temperature 0 degree. Then here water will convert into, change the temperature. Okay, so if you understand this, then you will understand all the problem for this chapter. Hope you understand.